this safe of secrets. We had heard rumors that the National Enquirer and or its parent company, AMI, had a safe of secrets where they kept stories on Donald Trump, who was then a candidate.
We also document multiple sourced documented accounts of a destruction of evidence before the election.
They were shredded.
There is an incident in the days before the 2016 election where we have employees saying that Dylan Howard, this senior AMI official, ordered documents to be removed from a safe and shredded.
Okay, so now tell us, what was on that list? What was in that safe?
So, you know, as with so many AMI stories, the story is about the process. The story is about the collaboration between Trump and this outlet and whether it violated election law. Obviously, AMI has signed a non-prosecution agreement admitting to potential violations of election law.
Okay, here's what AMI says about this, about you. Mr. Farrow's narrative is driven by unsubstantiated allegations from questionable sources, and while these stories may be dramatic, they are completely untrue.
I'll let the reporting in the book stand on its own. We're extremely confident in it, and those denials are included very clearly in the book. It's very fair. It's very meticulously fact-checked.
Damaging information that could have been helpful to voters during the 2016 election was stored in a safe and or killed by the National Enquirer. And just quickly, wouldn't it have helped them sell magazines if they'd put that out? Why did they do that?
Well, this is one of the curious narratives of that election cycle, that the Enquirer became an attack dog for Donald Trump. They have admitted that this was a coordinated collaboration, not only killing stories, but also actively going after leads to try to buy and bury them.
Here is what Dylan Howard's lawyer says about this. So this was the editor at the National Enquirer. Quote, we have advised Mr. Howard to make no further comment at this stage, while all legal options and jurisdictions are being considered.